In a previous video, I showed about how to backup an Android car stereo firmware. But that backup file size is very large. Therefore, I am going to show today a video about making a firmware as a fresh file. This will help you to save the storage. Watch the video. First, you have to create a scatter file by using WWR MTK software. Select the correct driver and create the scatter file. Then go to SP Flash Tools and under the Readback tab, remove all the data. Then add new one and double click on it. Then save the file as boot 1. Go to the created scatter file and copy data as shown in the video and click OK. Now click on Readback button and connect the car stereo system to the PC. Wait until the processing is completed. And follow the steps as shown in the video. If you have watched my previous video, you know how to do these steps. Now the ROM is also created. Next step is, you have to go to the WWR MTK software. Then select the created ROM file and click on Table of Section button. Then you can see the list of firmware files. Find the system file and copy the start address. Now again run SP Flash tool and click on Readback tab. Remove the existing data and create new one. Double-click on the new data and save it as ROM user. Then enter the copied address following the video. Now click on Readback button and connect the car stereo system. It will take a time to create the ROM file. Now we are going to create the firmware. You have to go again to the WWR MTK software and now you have to select the user ROM file. Then go to Start Autopilot tab and do the changes to settings as shown in the video and click on Start the Process button. Now it is started and wait for the completion. Then go to Assemble Firmware section and click on Collect Firmware for a Hard Reset button. In this process, you can create a firmware to hard reset the unit. Now, we are going to create the complete firmware. Click on Cut the ROM including user data button, then create a new folder to create the firmware. It will take few times to create. After all the processes are completed, you have your one firmware for your car stereo system. Save the files in a secured place. If you think this video is important to you, do not forget to like, share and subscribe my channel. I will see you with another important video. Be innovative and stay with SetNFix.